Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can search conditionally within MongoDB. Let's say that you want to find a certain number that is greater than or less than another certain number. That's what we're going to be covering in this video, and in the video description you'll find a link to the GitHub repository with this current project. If you want to code along with your own project, feel free to do that. And real quick before we start, if you have any questions or need help with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the warrenoffkeys Discord, and I'm sure someone will be able to help you there. So with that said, let's get started. First, I'm going to go inside of my schemas folder and go into my user schema. Here we have a basic schema, and let's say that we want a new property here. We'll just call this level, and this is going to be a number. And we then want to be able to search depending on people who are greater than or less than a certain level. So I'm going to go through and insert a new document real quick. So going into my index file, we have this simple thing that just simply connects to MongoDB. And I'm going to create a new schema, or a new document rather. So I'm going to minimize the explorer here, and I'm going to move the user schema into the right side pane, which is going to allow me to view it while coding along in index. So now I'm going to say await new user schema, and this is what I'm importing on line 2. I'm then going to have an object, and then afterwards I'm going to use .save. Now within this object is where I'm going to specify all my values. So for example, email can be testing at tests.com. You can use whatever example you want, of course. I'm going to add a comma, and then the username will be test. The pass will be abc123, and then the level will be 10. We can then save this. Going into my console, I can run node index.js. No errors occurred. Going into Chrome, to Mongo Atlas, I can then click on find to refresh this. And here we see our testing at test.com with a level of 10. Now let's say that we wanted to search for users who have a level greater than or equal to 5. So going back, I'm going to comment this out. I'm also going to add a comment saying creating a test user. And then I'm going to comment all of these out by selecting them and holding control and doing forward slash. Then here, I'm going to search for users with a level greater than 10. So I can say constant results. This will be a constant that will hold our results. We're just going to simply console log this here in a second. This is going to equal await user schema dot find, and then within here we have to have an object. Now within here we have to specify the field we want. In this case it is level, and then it has to have its own object. We could then say $greater than, and then we can say 5. Now after this entire expression, I can console log the results, and then we can save our code, and I can run this with node index.js like before, and we see our results is this array with this one object. Now, of course, the level is 10, like we've specified before, so if I change this greater than to 50, it's only going to return results that have a level greater than 50. Of course, 10 is not greater than 50, so this will not return anything. There we go, we have an empty array. So if I were to say greater than 10, this also will return no results because 10 is not greater than 10. So if I run this again, we'll get an empty array. But if we want to say greater than or equal to, we can use GTE for greater than equal to. I can then save this and run the code, and this should display our actual document, as it does right here. Now, we can also use less than or equal to. So less than or equal to 10 will still return our document, of course. But if I were to use less than, 10 is not less than 10, so we're going to return an empty array here. Now, let's say that we want to check to see if this field even exists, because within our schema, we see that level is not required, it's just a number. So within this level object right here, we can remove all of this, and we can say $exists is true. If I save this and I run it, we then get this right here because level does exist. So now if I were to go inside of the document using Mongo Atlas, we can go to level is 10. I can edit this and I can actually delete this right here. And now if I go back into my code and my console, I can run this again. And we get no results because there is currently no documents that have the levels array. Now, as you saw, there's two documents here. One is from a previous video. And so if I change exists to false, we're then going to get both of those returned because level does not exist on either of them now. The first one didn't have level. The second one, I just deleted level from. So if I run this, we now get both results. And so this is how you're going to use a couple of different conditional operators within MongoDB. Thanks for watching this MongoDB tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warrenoffkeys Discord, which will be linked in the video description. If you want to learn more about MongoDB, you can consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.